Funding for the production of Public Square provided by the W.K. Kellogg Foundation, working to improve the lives of vulnerable children.
Theater for me has made me want to go out there and experience life. It's made me set a goal for myself.
Dance is about physics. Because we embody the concepts, we actually put them on ourselves rather than just hear them and memorize them and write them down. We learn and remember so much more.
A lot of times our school systems are so set on like standardizing everything. Everything's gotta be like the same, and we wanna believe that everyone's brain works the exact same way and fits in a certain box.
If students are afraid and repressed and disrespected and looked at as something to be feared and something to be controlled and something to move through the hall and something to fill in a blank, that there's no room to learn.
Art has to be okay for parents to be able to understand it, for communities to be able to embrace it, for it to continue to exist, because that's the overlying reason why art doesn't happen in a lot of places, is because people are afraid of it.
Do you want the kids to buy into their own life? And we're so better served as a community if we can really encourage our kids to express themselves creatively.
Welcome to Public Square, where civic dialogue takes center stage.
When you can show math as it pertains to music, as it pertains to the patterns of nature, as it helps you create artworks, wow, suddenly it's an empowering tool.
The arts, they're often the first thing to be cut, but should they be? Today we talk about youth and the arts. What happens when kids get involved in theater, art, poetry, dance, and music? A growing body of research indicates these activities have profound cognitive impacts on students. They help boost their abilities in reading, memory, and math. They also increase students' engagement. Yet in policy debates, the arts are often viewed as a luxury rather than a necessity. We'll hear today from advocates and students about the impacts the arts have had on the lives of young people. Then, in our second half, we'll discuss policy and funding for the arts with Regina Chavez, Executive Director of Creative Albuquerque, State Representative Bill O'Neill, and State Senator Linda Lopez. Before we get started, here's more information on our topic.